home.
That's where I am from.
That's where I'm from.
That's where I am from. I am from home where I am.
Let's go to church.
Thank you. thank you, thank you.
Lord, we know we said thank you this morning, God, when we rose up out of our beds.
Yes, sir.
Lord, we know we said thank you when we made it home on today, God.
Yes.
But Lord, right now we're in your house, and we all should just say thank you, Lord, for blessing us to see another day.
Thank you.
Lord, you brought us in this world, God, and you would take us out.
Yes,
we all have enough to say thank you, God. You gave us life. You gave us more than life, God. God, we just pray that everyone be revived on tonight.
Jesus' name I can pray. Amen.
We thank you for our youth on participating tonight.
That's right.
That you could have been anywhere on tonight, but God led you down into the valley.
All right.
To worship and praise the God. Amen. If you're going to be in that quiet mode, make some noise.
Amen.
But if you're going to praise God on tonight, give him your all, praise God.
Amen.
Which one y'all going to do? Y'all going to be in the quiet mode?
All right.
Thank you. Yeah. say amen again.
Amen.
How many know there's a blessing in this house?
Amen.
Amen. I must say this, if you do, some of you act a little dry. Oh. I don't know about you. Yeah. If you get money in here, you're going to make some money. You've been going through and being with some things, and God has blessed you, delivered you, made way for you. The devil don't want you to pray for this. Because he wants you to thank him. He's not healing nobody. He's not delivering anyone. But the true worshipers of God supposed to respond. The Bible said, let the redeemer of the Lord say so. Amen. That's what the word says. Amen. In the word and you in the word, Jesus, if you're about it, me in the word about it, you, when you hear it, we're supposed to say so. Oh, you talking about my God. Amen. We got to give him some praise. Amen. Amen. All the things that's going on in the world today, you're complaining about this and what this and that. All you got to do is, the Bible says, draw closer to the Lord. And he'll handle that, and we can't handle it. But if you do your part for the Lord will do his part for you. Amen. How many know if you have a God business? You're having your business. You ain't got to lay awake tonight and worry about it. You can go on to sleep because he never sleep, not do his slumber. Amen. Amen. Some of the biggest mistakes we make in life is trying to work out our own problem. Amen. When we have a relationship with Jesus Christ, he's our problem solver. Now, Lord, you see it there. I'm going to let you have it. Amen. I'm going to know the Lord will have your back if you ask him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you. Amen. We thank God for the youth tonight.
Yes, sir. Amen.
It's youth night. We thank God for the youth tonight. There's never been a time that adult people need to praise and push the youth to time is now. They're dealing with some stuff inside and outside. Amen. I'm the church that unbelievable. Amen. And the demonic spirits is on the loose. So, amen. We're going to hold fast to our children and keep them in the admiration of the Lord. We got to let them know that we're in Jesus. And whatever you go through, no matter how much pressure you put under, when you can't handle it, give it to Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Bless you.
Amen.
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 We're going to ask Morningstar. We ask Morningstar to come.
Amen.
We'll make sure that any other choir in the house, we want to make sure we recognize everybody. Thank you, Mama. Amen. Amen. I want to know when. When she finished, we're going to ask the old lady in charge tonight to come and lift the offering. And while they're lifting the offering, Morningstar, we want you to take the choir stand, come out of the offering table, and come on into the choir stand.
Yeah.
Give the Lord a big round of applause.
All right.
Yeah.
Praise God. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
What a mighty God.
Yeah.
We serve.
Hi, Lord.
What a mighty God.
Oh,
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for another day. Another moment that blesses your life. Let something be said from that to trigger our heart. Let our soul cry out, Lord, let us do to be saved. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Preachers all over. Give all the ministers and pastors a hand. The nice morning's about to give us an A selection. Then we have to represent the speaker to you all tonight, because we know that everybody knows him.
Amen.
We're going to present him to him. We're going to have to introduce him. Amen.
Amen.
Come on, start hand while they sing.
You can't have my, you can't, I plead the blood.
My hallelujah belongs to you. Somebody know what I'm talking about. You deserve it. And all of the glory.
All of the glory belongs to you.
Yes, it does. Yes, it does.
All of the glory belongs to you.
Spencer, God. Thank you for everyone that's here right now. Thank you for morning, God. Thank you, God, for your presence. Thank you for your spirit, God. Thank you for your power. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah, God. We bless your name right now, Lord. We lift you up right now, Lord. We say, have your way right now, Master. Lord, as we stand before your people, God, we pray, Lord, that you would speak tonight, Lord. That you would speak through us, Lord God. Use us as your vessel, as your instrument, Lord, to stand, Lord God, and declare your word, oh Master. Lord, that your people will be blessed through the hearing of your word, God. Lord, let the words of my mouth, the meditation of my heart, Father, be acceptable in thy sight. For Lord, you're our strength and our redeemer. It is in Jesus' most holy, merciful, mighty, and matchless name we do pray and ask it all. Amen. Amen. Come on and give God one more hand praise in this place. If you don't mind joining in with me, why don't you give him a hallelujah in this place? Somebody tell him hallelujah. This is the day the Lord has made. I've already made up in my mind. I will rejoice and I will be glad in it. Regardless of what comes my way, I know that the Lord is with me. And as long as I know that the Lord is with me, is there anybody like me know that everything is going to be all right? Oh, bless his name. Truly, we give honor to God, our Father, Jesus Christ, his Son, and to the precious Holy Spirit. Amen. We give honor to your, amen, most honorable pastor. Amen. And I have to say, a dear friend of mine. Amen. Pastor Spencer, you all show him some love. Amen. Amen. I thank God for him. Amen. Whenever I call on him, amen. It had already been booked up by 4 or 5 more churches. Amen. Amen. Said he'd be glad to come. Praise God. Amen. Amen. We thank God. Amen. I thank God for him and his friendship. Amen. Amen. He's been there. Amen. I can tell you he's been there. Amen. As a friend to me, amen, when I was going through some times, amen, rough times in my life, amen, but yet he was right there, and I thank God for him. Amen. I thank God for you, Lily Valley. Amen. Amen. I thank God for you, Lily Valley. Amen. I thank God, amen, for your, amen, support. I thank God for your acceptance, amen, of this recommendation to come and share a word from heaven, amen. And I just thank God because, amen, with sister churches, amen, and amen, fellowship regularly together, amen. So, amen, when I'm here, amen, Pastor, I do feel, amen, like I'm at home. Amen, because, amen, I thank God, amen, for the fellowship that we share, amen, between Lily Valley and Morningstar. Amen, truly, I thank God for my beloved Morningstar. Amen, amen. Amen. Most of them are in the choir stand. Amen. And there's others that are outside. Amen. That are not in the choir stand. Amen. If you would raise your hand. Amen. We're just so grateful for Morningstar. Give Morningstar some love. Praise the Lord. Amen. 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 Y'all already know about, amen, Deacon Thomas Clark. Amen.
All right.
President. Amen. Deacon Board. Amen. And the Usher Board. Praise all God. Right. So we're just so grateful. Amen. To have him with us. Amen. All of our deacons. Amen. Thank God. Amen. For our beloved. Amen. Sister Barbara, who's with us as well. Amen. Anybody here know God is blessing you right now?
Yeah.
Anybody here know you're blessed?
Yeah.
Amen. Amen, amen. Just in case you're not sure, amen. I don't know, maybe you didn't catch what happened down in Florida. Amen. Maybe you missed out on what went down over in Texas. Amen. And yet you can look at yourself today. Amen. And see how God kept us. Amen. In the midst of it all and kept us through it all. And, amen. And I like to even say, amen, he took it easy. He allowed that storm to ease up. Amen. Even down in Florida, amen, amen. When it could have been a whole lot worse.
Yeah.
Amen. I thank God. Amen. And it lets me know one thing, amen, Lily Valley. It lets me know, Morningstar, amen, that God is still in control.
Yeah.
Amen. Regardless of what goes on in this life, regardless of what goes on in this world, amen, God is still in charge. Amen. Nothing happens that catches God off guard. Amen. What is good, though, to know that your life is in God's hands. Amen. No matter what comes, no matter how much the storm rages, amen, it's good to know that my life is in God's hands. Amen. And as long as I know that my life is in God's hands, amen, I still already know that everything is going to be all right. Amen. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. We're not going to, amen, hold you long, amen. Spirit of the Lord says so. We'd like to call your attention, amen, to the book of Isaiah.
All right.
Amen. Isaiah, amen, a major prophet, amen, of the Old Testament, amen. Yeah. Beyond Psalms, amen. Beyond, Proverbs, beyond the Song of Solomon, beyond Ecclesiastes, amen, beyond Lamentations, amen. You're about to run into Brother Isaiah.
All right.
Amen. Amen. Isaiah, the 37th chapter.
All right.
Amen. We're going to begin reading with verse number 14, read down through verse 21, and then jump over to verse 33 and read through verse 36 in your hearing. Amen. This is a, amen, complete chapter. Amen. But amen, just a few verses in your hearing. Amen. Isaiah, the 37th chapter. Amen. Beginning with verse 14, we'll read down through verse number 21 and then verse 33 through verse 36 in your hearing.
Amen.
Amen. When you found it, say amen.
Amen.
Amen. I know there may be some that, amen, amen, spend time as much in the Old Testament and amen. So you may have to, amen, peel the pages a little bit. Amen. But amen. If you run into Jeremiah,
I'm all right.
Amen. You run too far. Amen. If you run into Ezekiel and Daniel, you're truly, amen, you've gone too far. Amen. Amen. Isaiah, the 37th chapter. Amen. Beginning with verse number 14. Amen. The word of God reads as thus. And Hezekiah received the letter.
All right.
Amen. From the hand of the messengers.
Mm-hmm.
And read it. And Hezekiah went up into the house of the Lord. And spread it before the Lord. And Hezekiah prayed unto the Lord, saying, O Lord of hosts, God of Israel, thou dwellest, amen, that dwelleth between, amen, the cherubims. Thou art the God, even thou alone, of all the kingdoms of the earth, amen, thou hast made heaven and earth. Incline thine ear, O Lord, and hear, open thine eyes, O Lord, and see and hear all the words of Sennacherib, amen, which has, amen, who has sent, amen, to reproach the living God. Of a truth, Lord, the king of Assyria hath laid waste all of the nations and their countries,
yes, Lord,
and have cast their gods into the fire, for they were no gods,
yes,
but the work of men's hands,
yes,
wood and stone. Therefore, they have destroyed them.
Yes, Lord.
Now, therefore, O Lord our God,
yes,
save us from his hand,
yes,
that all the kingdoms of the earth may know that thou art the Lord,
yes,
even thou only.
Yes,
then Isaiah the son of Amos sent unto Hezekiah, saying, thus saith the Lord, God of Israel, amen, whereas thou hast prayed, amen, to me against Sennacherib, king of Assyria, amen, this is the word, amen, verse 22, amen, this is the word which the Lord has spoken concerning him.
Amen.
The virgin, the daughter of Zion, has despised thee and has laughed thee to scorn. Amen. The daughter of Jerusalem has shaken her head at thee. Amen. Moving over with me to verse number 33. Amen. Through verse 36.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. Same chapter. Said, therefore, saith the Lord. Thus saith the Lord. Concerning the king of Assyria. He shall not come, amen, into the city. Nor shoot an arrow there. Nor come before it with shields. Nor cast the bank against it. By the way that he came, by the same shall he return. Shall not come a man into the city, saith the Lord. For I will defend the city to save it for mine own sake and for my servant David's sake. Then the angel of the Lord went forth and smote in the camp of the Assyrians. Amen. 185,000. And when they arose early in the morning, behold, they were all dead corpses.
My Lord.
Amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Almighty God, the God of the blessed, the readers, the hearers, and the doers of his holy and divine word.
All right.
Amen. From these passages of scriptures, amen, others that we may allude to along the way, amen, I want to use, amen, for a thought tonight, amen, for an encouragement tonight. Take it to the Lord in prayer.
Amen.
Amen. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Amen. Amen. I believe that word is for somebody this tonight. Amen. So, amen. Just look at your neighbor. Look at your neighbor. Amen. And tell your neighbor, or neighbor,
no matter what it is,
take it to the Lord
in prayer.
Amen. Come on and give God a hand praise in this place. In this day and time. Amen. And we talked about it already. We look, amen, at all that is taking place. Amen. And we recognize that we're living in the last days. We're living in perilous times. We're living, amen, in an age where, amen, the Bible is fulfilling itself. Amen. We're living in an age where, amen, just as the scripture said, the love of many has waxed cold. Amen. People don't care for one another like they used to. Not only that, people will do anything and everything they can against one another. Amen. Amen. That's no concern about one another's welfare. Amen. It's a me, myself, and I thing. Amen. I'm going to get mine, whether it means getting yours in the process. Amen. Amen. But I got news for you today. Amen. Regardless of what's going on, amen. Amen. You can have confidence in knowing that you can take it to the Lord in prayer. Amen. Amen. Many of us, amen, have been afflicted, amen, by sicknesses. Amen. Have been afflicted by pains, aches, amen, in our bodies. Our health, amen, don't seem to hold up like it used to. Amen. Our steps are getting a little shorter. Amen. The doctor, amen, is giving us reports. Amen. That, amen, we used to get good reports, and now they're telling, amen, I see this and I see that. Amen. But I got news for you and good news and encouragement for you tonight. Amen. Regardless of what the doctor said, amen, you can take it to the Lord in prayer. Just to piggyback on something, amen, that Pastor said, amen, when he was over at Morningstar, amen, I got news for you. Prayer still works. Prayer will change things. Amen, amen. Not because of who you are, but because of the one who you're talking to. Because of the one to whom you're going to. Amen, amen. Somebody here needs to know you can take it to the Lord in prayer. Amen, amen. Prayer. The Bible says, amen, in John, amen, it lets us know that, amen, the prayer of the righteous availeth much. Amen. I believe it was James. James said, the prayer of the righteous availeth much. Amen, amen. If any man is sick, if any man, amen, is going through, he said, let them call for the elders. Let them come, amen, anoint them with oil, pray over them, amen, and the prayer of faith shall save the sick. Somebody here needs to know that, amen, the Lord will hear and answer prayer. Amen, the Bible says, amen, that the Lord's eyes, amen, are in every place. Amen, beholding the good and the evil. Amen. It said that his ears are open to the cries of his children. Amen. And one thing about God, God can't stand to see his children cry. Amen. Amen. God can't stand to see his children cry. And when they cry out unto him, amen, I need you to know that he will hear and he will answer prayer. Amen. And you can count on it. Amen. Listen, amen. When I'm going through something, amen, I can't always count on me. Amen. But one thing I know, I can count on God. Amen. There are some things man just can't do. Amen. Man has limits. Man has, amen, only so much that they can do, only so far that they can go. But I serve a God that can do the unlimited. I serve a God who can do the impossible. I serve a God that can make the impossible become possible. Amen. Somebody here needs to know that there's nothing too hard for God. Amen, amen. I heard Jesus, amen, the disciples, amen, went to Jesus one day and they saw him praying and they told him they asked him to teach us how to pray. Amen. Jesus taught them, amen, the model prayer. Amen, amen. But it's time for us as believers, amen, to grow up some. Amen. And to recognize that, amen, no matter what it is that you're dealing with, no matter what it is that you're facing, amen, you can take it to the Lord in prayer. Amen, amen. Listen, ain't no sense of trying to hold it back anyhow. God already knows about it. Amen. But all he's waiting on you to just let it go and let him have it. Amen. The problem a lot of times, we still try to hold on to it. We still try to fix it. We still try to work it out. We still try to make it happen. And most of the time, we end up making it worse. Amen. But I got news for you. When you learn how to take it to the Lord, and when you learn how to leave it there,
And when you learn how to go on like it's already done, amen, watch God begin to work on that situation. When you learn how to walk in faith and just believe that he's already made a way, watch God begin to move by your faith. Amen. The Bible said, amen, amen, without faith it is impossible to please God. Amen. So that lets me know that when I show a measure of faith, amen, that God is pleased and God begins to move on my behalf. Amen, amen. Regardless of what it is, y'all, amen, prayer still works. Amen. The Lord will answer prayer. Amen. Somebody here needs to know that he is a miracle working God. Amen, amen. I don't care what the doctor has diagnosed. Cancer is not too hard for the Lord. Diabetes is not too hard for the Lord. AIDS is not too hard for the Lord. Amen. I'm glad to tell you, amen, Hurricane Irma was not too hard for the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen, amen. All you got to do is take it to the Lord. Amen. And I just believe there were some folks on bending knees. I just believe there were some folks saying, Lord, shut the storm down. I just believe somebody was saying, Lord, bring it down. Let there be minimal damage. Let there be minimal life lost, Lord God. I just believe in it. Amen. The more I watch it, the more I see how God moved in a mighty way. Amen. Across the land. Amen. Amen. It's because the saints of God are praying. Amen. If there's ever was a time that the saints of God need to be praying, now is the time. As we see all of the things that are taking place, it lets us know the time is winding up. It lets us know the time that then won't be no more. We're getting closer now than we've ever been before. Amen. But in the process, the world seems to be getting worse. Or the people of the world seem to be getting worse. Amen. They're doing everything they're big and bold enough to do. Amen. They'll even attack you. They'll even steal from you. They'll even mistreat you. Amen. They won't think nothing else about it. Amen. But I got news for you. Amen. Regardless of how bad it seems, you can still take it to the Lord in prayer. Amen. I told you. Amen. It don't matter what it is. Amen. It doesn't matter what it is. Amen. There's nothing, amen, that you can hide from God anyhow. Amen. We worry ourselves trying to keep stuff to ourselves. When God says, cast your cares upon me, for he cares for you. Is there anybody here today know that the Lord cares for you? I got a news for you. If you don't know it, yes, he does. Not only that he cares, but he loves you. Amen. And he wants to see his children blessed. Amen, amen. I got news for you also that if you're lost today, amen, and you've been struggling, you've been striving, you've been trying to be a good person. Amen. And the more it seems like you try, the more it seems like you fail. Amen. I got news for you. You can go to the Lord in prayer. Say, Lord, I'm a sinner. Lord, I'm a sinner. But God, I know that you're God. I know that your son Jesus lives. That he lived, that he died, and that he rose again. Amen. And I know that, amen, he's able to save me. Amen. And so here I am, Lord, come into my life, save me. I acknowledge that you are, amen, the Son of God. I acknowledge that you died and that you rose again. And my Bible said, if you do that, thou shalt be saved. Amen. I got news for you. It does not matter what you've done. It does not matter how bad you've been. It does not matter how far you strayed away. It does not matter to God. What matters is that you come back to the Lord. And when you come back, amen, the Bible lets me know that he will receive you. Amen. If you're struggling today, take it to the Lord in prayer. As a believer, amen, there's so much that we're faced with. Amen. We get upset. We get angry. Sometimes we want to lash out. And sometimes stuff come out of our mouth that, amen, shouldn't come out. And then we find ourselves feeling bad about it afterwards. And we want God, amen, we want to be able to overcome, amen, that type of situation. We want to be able to overcome the urge and the temptation to give in. Here am I, God. Here am I. Jesus said, man ought always pray and not faint.
Amen. Regardless of what it is, amen, keep on praying. Amen, amen. The old folks say amen, and amen. I found myself saying the same thing. He may not come when you want him, but he's always right on time. Is there anybody here know that we serve an on-time God? Is there anybody here know that when he show up, he knows how to work it out? Won't he do it tonight? All you gotta do is just take it to the Lord in prayer. Amen, amen. As I look at my message, as we hurry on tonight, amen, amen. I see a man by the name of King Hezekiah. Amen, Hezekiah, amen, had come to the throne in the last years of his father. Amen, his father was named Ahaz. Ahaz was a wicked king. Amen, amen, had Israel and Jerusalem in idolatry. Amen, but amen, ain't you glad that you got a good mama? Amen, a good mama that stayed in church, that kept you in church and tried to tell you what's right. Amen, and even though everybody else seemed to be going one way, amen, mama said keep your hand in God's hands. Mama said stay on the right road. Mama said trust in the Lord. Amen, mama said give your life to the Lord. Amen, so Hezekiah remembered what mama said. Amen, amen, and Hezekiah made up in his mind that regardless of what everybody else does, even if daddy don't go, I'm going on for the Lord. Amen. So eventually Hezekiah became king of Israel and Jerusalem. Amen. He became king of Jerusalem and Judah. Amen. And once he was in office, amen, once he was the main man, amen, the Bible said that he started a revival in the land of Judah. Amen. Tore down all the altars. Amen. Moved all the worship places back to the city of Jerusalem. Amen. So that when people came, they had to come to Jerusalem to worship the Lord. Amen. Because of the temptation out there, amen, to follow after other gods. Amen. He wanted to make sure that the central place of worship was in Jerusalem. Amen. That lets me know every now, amen, amen, we need to find our way back to church. We need to find our way back to the central place of worship. Too many of us got the mindset, I can do it at home. Too many of us got the mindset, I can watch it on television. Amen. But God got a word for you in the house. Amen. God got a word for you in the place, in the house of worship. Amen. And your word, you can't get it from television. And you can't get it on your own. You got to get it from the man of God. Amen. In the place of worship. Amen. But the Bible said that, amen, Judah, amen, Jerusalem was besieged by the king of Assyria. And the Assyrian army had begun to press their way toward Jerusalem. Amen. The Assyrian army, amen, the king of Assyria was named Sennacherib. Amen. And they had already taken over many of the countries around Jerusalem. They had already even taken over, amen, Samaria and the land of Israel. Amen. And God had allowed them to do so, amen, because of Israel's disobedience. Amen. I got news for you today. Amen. You can't do wrong and get by. Amen. I got news for you today. Amen. It doesn't matter whether you're, amen, saved or not. Amen. No sin shall go unpunished. Amen. But aren't you glad that you have a God? Amen. That even when I mess up, amen, I can go and take it to the Lord and say, Lord, I'm sorry. And he will forgive me of my sins. Amen. He will restore me. Amen. I'm glad I can take it to the Lord in prayer. Because I know that I'm not perfect. Amen. I know that every now and then I mess up. Amen. It's just good to know that I got somebody I can turn to. Amen. And if we were living in the Old Testament days, if we were living under the law, amen, the penalty for sin was death. Amen. But I thank God that we're not living under that anymore. I thank God that we're covered under grace and truth through the blood of Jesus Christ. Amen. That we don't get what we deserve, but he gives us mercy and grace, what we need. Anybody here glad about it today? Let's hold it along. Amen. The Bible said that the king of Assyria, amen, was arrogant. Amen. He was arrogant. He was braggadocious. Amen. He would boast about his conquest. And he even had the audacity to send servants into Jerusalem to tell them and to let them know, amen, you might as well give up. You might as well quit. You might as well throw in the towel. Ain't no hope for you. Amen. We're coming, and when we come, we're going to take it over. Amen. You might as well surrender now. Amen. But then, what? I can understand, amen, people. Amen. That's just war talk. Amen. But the pastor, he stepped over the line. Amen. He stepped over the line. Amen. Because not only did he threaten them and tell them that we're going to get you. Amen. But he told them, your God that you serve won't even be able to save you. He told them, you might as well stop trusting in him. You might as well stop listening to Hezekiah and telling you that God will deliver you. Amen. Is there anybody in here that know that God is able to deliver? Is there anybody in here that know that God will fight your battles? Is there anybody here know that you can stand still and watch God fight your battles? Somebody say he's a battle axe. Somebody say he's Jehovah Nisi. He fights my battles. Hallelujah. So I ain't got to worry. All I got to do is take it to the Lord in prayer. Amen. Amen. The Bible said that the servants just began to boast and told them, if you're trusting in Egypt, you might as well forget about it. Ain't nothing they can do for you. But most of all, if you're trusting in the God, in your God, you might as well hang it up. Amen. Because the reason why I'm here is because your God allowed it to be so. Amen. Amen. And if you're trusting in him, amen, you might as well forget it. Amen. But ain't it good that you have somebody? Lily Valley, amen. It's good to know that you got a man of God that trusts in God, that believes in God, that's standing on the word of God, that know the word of God, and recognize the voice of God, and is able to tell the difference between the voice of God and the voice of Satan. That's able to tell the difference between the voice of God and the voice of man. Amen. Somebody that trusts God enough to know that no matter what anybody else says, no matter how bad the situation might seem, no matter how bleak it might look, I still got a God that's able to step in and make right what's wrong in my life. Somebody here know he'll do it. He'll do it. Amen. So, amen. The Bible said that, amen, when Hezekiah got the message. Amen. The Bible said that, amen, in verse 14, it said Hezekiah, when he received the letter, amen, from the hand of the messenger. And after he had read it, the Bible said that Hezekiah went up into the house of the Lord, amen, and spread it before the Lord. Amen. That brings me, amen, to something. Amen. One of the things I want to share with you. Amen. When things are going wrong in your life, amen, staying at home ain't the answer. Amen. On the phone talking to your friends ain't the answer. Amen. Listening to Oprah and Dr. Phil ain't the answer. Amen. None of the rest of them is not the answer. Amen. They got problems just like you do. Ain't going all right today. But I found out that when I'm going through, hallelujah, it's a good time to find my way down to the house of God. Ain't God all right? Just to be in his presence. Ain't God all right? Just to be where he is. Just to bow down before him. Ain't God all right? You need to assemble yourself in the house of God. Hallelujah. Not only that, but there's some other folks that's in the house, hallelujah, that's concerned about you, that'll pray with you and pray for you. Ain't God all right? And it's good to know that the prayer of the righteous availeth much. Ain't God all right? Hallelujah. So you ought to find your way to the house of God. Let the man of God know that I'm going through. Ain't God all right? But most of all, give it to the Lord. Listen, trouble is trouble. Ain't God all right? And what you going through, don't nobody know it like you know it. Ain't God all right? And don't nobody know how you feel like you do. Ain't God all right? I got news for you. Hallelujah. Regardless of what it is, acknowledge the reality of whatever you're going through. Ain't God all right? Watch what Hezekiah did. Hallelujah. In verse number 15, he said, and Hezekiah prayed unto the Lord, saying, O Lord of hosts, God of Israel, hallelujah, and thou that dwellest between the cherubims, thou art the God, and even thou alone. And God, all right, when you go to the Lord, when you take it to him in prayer, you ought to acknowledge who he is. And God, all right, the first thing some of us do, give me this, do that. And God, all right, when you go to the Lord, you ought to first of all acknowledge who God is. He's a God who sits high and looks low. He's a God. He's so great. He's greater than my situation. He's greater. He's the creator of the whole world. And God, all right, he's the one that spoke life and man into man. He's the one that breathed and breathed into man, and man became a living soul. And God, all right, he's the one that said, let there be, and there was. And God, all right, he's the one that said, let us make man in our image and after our likeness, and in form and shape man and breathe into his nostrils, and man became a living soul. And God, all right, he's the one that made the light from the darkness. He's the one that made the day from the night. Is there anybody here that know he is? When you go to him, you ought to acknowledge. You see, Pastor, when I go to him, I know I'm not going to my regular, my biological daddy. My biological daddy can only do so much. And God, all right, when I go to him, I'm not going to the soothsayer. Hallelujah. I'm not going to the doctor. When I go to him, I'm going to the doctor of doctors. And God, all right, I'm going to the one who labor to heal unto the utmost. When I go to him, I'm going to the one who labor to save to the utmost. And God, all right, is there anybody here that know who he is? If you know who he is, say it. Acknowledge who he is. And God, all right, acknowledge, let him know, acknowledge the reality of what you're going through. And God, all right, I heard Hezekiah say, Lord, look, Lord, look at this letter that the king of Assyria had wrote to fold it to you, unto me. And not only did he write it to me, but in the process, he reproached you. And God, all right, hallelujah, I find it strange, hallelujah, we'll back up everybody else, we'll stand for everybody else, we'll support everybody else, but if they say something about God, I don't believe there's a God. Hallelujah, we got the hush mouth. Jesus is just a man, we won't say nothing. But don't let him talk about Michael. Don't let him talk about LeBron. Hallelujah. Don't let him talk about President Obama. We'll stand up in a heartbeat. But let him talk about Jesus. And don't act like they ain't got nothing to say. But somebody ought to have information. If you're talking about Jesus, he is a friend of mine.
Bible said that Hezekiah, he accepted the reality. He acknowledged the reality because I heard him say, Lord, it's true. It's true that the king of Assyria, he's already taken the other countries. He's already overtaken Samaria. Yes, he did. He's already destroyed their gods. It's true that he's a bad boy. It's true that he's a rough one to tangle with. Ain't God all right? Somebody here need to acknowledge your situation. Stop trying to hide it. He already knows about it. You ought to let him have it. Stop beating around the bush and say, Lord, it's me, Lord. I'm struggling. I'm striving. I'm wrestling. I'm going through. I got sickness in my body. The doctor that gave me a bad report. The doctor said it's cancer. The doctor said he see a spot. Lord, I'm scared. You're struggling with sin in your life. Stop dodging it. Stop beating around the bush and say, Lord, I'm having trouble. I can't take my eyes off little Sylvia and little Sheila. Ain't God all right? I can't leave John and Jerry alone. Ain't God all right? You got to be real with God. The doctor, you don't tell the doctor your ear ache if you got a stomach ache. You said, Doctor, my stomach is hurting. Ain't God all right? Be real, accept the reality, and let God know about it because He already knows anyway. He just wants you to let it go and let Him have it. Ain't God all right? Hezekiah said, Lord, it's true that He's already done these things. Already destroyed their gods. Ain't God all right? But one thing he did acknowledge, and this is another thing I want to let you know, acknowledge his supremacy. Ain't God all right? Acknowledge that he is the only true and living God. He is the only God of heaven. He is a God that's none like him. There's none but him. Ain't God. Anyway, ain't God all right? Because you, Lord, are the one and only true and living God. Acknowledge His supremacy. And when you acknowledge His supremacy, ain't God all right? The next thing you need to do is tell God what you want. Ain't God all right? Listen to Hezekiah. Tell the Lord, 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 save this city. Save us from the king of Assyria. Ain't God all right? We need you. We just can't make it without you. Is there anybody here that ever told the Lord, Lord, I need you. Lord, save me. Lord, deliver me. Lord, break me through. Lord, heal me. Lord, deliver me out of it. Lord, take that away from me. Won't He do it? Save us, Lord. Save us. Is there anybody here ever got down on your knees and told the Lord, I can't stand the storm. I need you to save me. Yeah. Give it to him. Let him have it. Ask for what you want. Hallelujah. Somebody here needs to know. He's on the main line, Pastor. Tell him what you want.
in the noonday, tell him in the midnight hour, tell him right in the thick of it, tell him, tell him, tell him, tell him. Give it to the Lord. The Bible said, he said, Lord, save us. And then the next thing I want you to do, while you're praying, while you're giving it to him, don't just do it for yourself. Don't just pray it for yourself. Don't just ask it for yourself. But whatever you ask for, ask it for God's glory to be revealed. Ask it for God to get the glory. Ain't going all right. Whatever you do, you ought to do it to the glory of God. You ought to want God to be glorified. He said, Lord, for your sake, Lord, for your honor, that the nations around may know that you are the true and the living God, that they may know that you are the only God, that they may know that there's no other God but you, that they may know that there's nobody but you, that there's nobody like you, Lord. Let them see it, God. Do it for your glory. Defend this city for your sake, God. Whatever you do, whatever you pray for, whatever you ask God for, you ought to want God to be glorified. See, I don't want them just to heal cancer, just to heal cancer. I want them to heal cancer so that somebody know that he's a healer. That cancer's not too hard for him. I don't want them to save my child just to save my child. I want them to know that he's able to save to the utmost. Hallelujah. I don't want them to pay my bills. Just to pay my bills, but I want somebody else to know that he's able. All you got to do is trust him. All you got to do is give it to him and watch God make a way. Won't he do it? Won't he come through? See ya.
It's all right now.
I don't want him to bring me out just to bring me out, but I want somebody else to know that he's able to bring you out. And if he did it for me, he can do it for you. Hallelujah. If he did it before, he can do it again. I want somebody here to know that he's the same God, hallelujah, that brought me through. And Brother Dee, he was able to bring you through also. All you got to do is just let it go. Give it to him. Turn it over. Hallelujah. Because this thing, Brother Melvin, ain't just about me, but it's about him. And about him being glorified. So I want to let somebody know that whatever he did for me, I want them to know that it was God that did it. I don't care what the doctor said. My trust is not in the doctor, but my trust is in Jesus. He can work it out. He can fix it. He can do it. And if anybody know he can, and if anybody here that's done trying him for yourself, and if anybody here that took your problems to the Lord, did you find out that he's a problem solver? From your eyes, anybody here know he can? I want you to know that he can. Hallelujah. And every time he does it for me, I want to let somebody know that he did. Hallelujah. I got to close this thing. I got to let you go home. But amen, the Bible said that God heard Hezekiah's prayer.
Yes.
want you to know this, when you give it to the Lord, when you open up with a sincere heart, when you acknowledge who he is, when you acknowledge his supremacy, when you ask him for what you need, the Bible said that he will hear and he will answer prayer. The Bible said the Lord laid word, gave word to Isaiah, told Isaiah to tell Hezekiah, I heard your prayer.
Yes.
Told Isaiah to tell Hezekiah, this is what the Lord said about it. This is what the Lord said. The Lord said that I'm going to defend this city. The Lord said I'm going to deliver Judah out of the hand of the Assyrians. The Lord said that he won't be able to come against the city. He won't be able to step into the city. He won't be able to shoot a dart against the city. He won't be able to throw a bank against the city. And God, all right, he said, I'm going to defend this city for my name's sake. And God, all right, I'm going to let the nations of the world know that you're my child. I got news for you. God will do the same thing for you. He'll let folks see the handwork of him in your life. And folks won't help but to have to acknowledge that surely the Lord is with you. They can't help but to acknowledge that it was nobody but the Lord that saved you. They know how rotten you were, and to see the change that's come over your life, they have to acknowledge it was nobody but the Lord. Doctor told you 6 months, it's 6 years later. They have to acknowledge there was nobody but the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. They know you were going through struggles. They know you were going through heartaches. They know you were crying your eyes out. And now you run around the church with joy. Now you got a dance and a praise in your heart and on your feet. Amen. And they have to acknowledge it was nobody but the Lord. He's able, and he'll take care of his children. He wants to take care of his children, and all he wants his children to do is just give it to him. Turn it over to the Lord. Let him have it and watch him make a way. Watch him work it out. Watch him bring you through. Watch him open doors. Watch him prepare the way. Watch him close doors behind you. Watch him make your enemies become your footstool. Watch him heal your body. Watch him regulate your mind. Watch him give you peace. Watch him give you joy. Won't he do it? I ain't telling you what I heard. I'm telling you what I know. Because I tried him for myself. And I tried him, and I know that he's able to do it. God will take care of his children. All you got to do is just put it in his hands. Somebody said, let go and let God. And watch him make a way. The reason I know he can do it, because over 2,000 years ago, over 2,000 years ago, amen, they took my Savior, amen, and they hung him on that old rugged cross. And they thought they had got the best of him. They thought they had got rid of him. They thought they had shut him up. They thought they had shut him down. But all they did was just set him up for his glory to be revealed. Because somebody here know the word that the Lord said that if I be lifted up from the laid him in a tomb. Stayed there 3 days, but early Sunday morning, he got up with all power in his hand. And that power lets me know that there's nothing too hard for him. There's nothing that can stop him. Amen. He is able to do everything but fail. And so all you got to do is just turn it over
over to him. I close with this. Amen. Hezekiah told the people, keep trusting in God. The Lord had already told them that he was going to deliver. So the last thing I tell you, go ahead and act on your faith. Act on your belief. Act like it's already done. That means when I leave from the altar, I don't carry my burden back with me. I don't walk with my head down. I don't sit there and have pity parties. I hold my head up and I go on like victory is already mine. I go on like my blessing is on the way. I go on like my deliverance is already here. And when I lay down at night, I fold my arms aside of my head and I go on out to sleep and I can rest because I know that my life is in God's hands and he's going to work. Children of Israel, Jerusalem, sat up all night long? No. Bible said, during the night while they were asleep, God dismissed an angel, amen, into the camp of the Assyrians. And the Bible said that he smote, that he slayed 185,000 soldiers out in the camp of the Assyrians. They never got a chance to put foot in Israel because the angel of God slew them all and gone all right. And then early the next morning, when the children woke up and looked out over the wall, they saw soldiers lying dead everywhere. I don't know about you, but if I'd have been there, I would have begun to praise. I would have broke out in a dance. And I'd have been like, mother, what a mighty God. And does anybody know that he's able? I don't care what you're going through today. I don't care what your situation is today. No matter how many tears you cry, no matter how long you wrestle with it, this is your day. This is your moment. You don't have to struggle with that thing any longer. You don't have to carry that load any longer. You don't have to bear that heavy burden any longer. All you got to do is turn it over.
Yes, sir.
Take it to the Lord in prayer. And leave it there. And then go on and act like it's already done. Folks know that it's still you're going through some stuff. But you wear a smile anyhow. Folks know that it ain't all good in your house. But you keep on praising them anyhow. Folks know that you don't have a whole lot of money. You're struggling from week to week to make bills in, pay your bills. But you go on anyhow and put your tithes on the table. Hallelujah. Because God will. He's on the way. Work it out.
Yes, sir.
He's gonna fix it. Yes, hallelujah. All you gotta do is let him have it. If you're saved and you're struggling with temptations and trials, hallelujah. If the enemy is all, it seems like you're tripping and amen, falling more than you're standing. Amen. Listen, you gotta understand, just because you're saved, amen, don't mean the devil walked away from you.
All right.
Matter of fact, you enemy number one. And he's gonna come at you with everything he got. And you need somebody that's gonna help you to be able to stand. Give it to the Lord. So, Lord, I can't do it on my own. I need you. Hallelujah. And I got news for you. He'll do it today. He'll do it. If you're lost, if you don't know Jesus, if you just trying to be the best person you can without him, I got news for you. You can't do it on your own. You can't do it on your own. So many trials, so many temptations are out there. The enemy knows just what to come at you with. You got to have somebody that'll help you to make it, that'll help you to stand, that'll help you to overcome. Amen. And that man is Jesus. And if you don't know him tonight, I extend an invitation unto you to come. Turn it over to him. Say, Lord, here am I.
I can't do this on my own. I need you, Lord. Save me. Save me for your glory. And I got news for you. He'll do it today. This is your day. This is your moment. This is your time. This is your opportunity. You don't have to go another day without him. You can make it today. You can have him today. You can have peace today. You can have rest today. You can have joy today. He will fill your life with love. Hallelujah. He'll give you peace of mind. All you got to do is just give it to him. Turn it over to the Lord.
All right now.
The doors of the church is open. The doors of the church is open. Stand to your feet all over this building. Hallelujah. God knows. He already knows. He already sees. He knows the burdens of your heart. He knows the tears that you shed. He knows the trouble, the struggles, the trial that you've been going through. And all he's saying today is just let me have it. All he's saying today is just surrender it to me. I stop by to tell you, God, our limitations are just God's opportunity to show us just how awesome and just how powerful he really is. All you got to do is give it today. Hallelujah. He loves you. He cares. This is your moment. This is your day. If I were you, I'd come. We extend an invitation unto you. If you don't know Jesus, this is your day. You ought to come and give your life to him. Let him in your life. Let him be Lord of your life. Let him give you the peace, the joy that you so desire. You're missing something when you don't have him. And that is the joy that he's able to give. The love that he's able to give and fulfill your life with. I dare you to let go and let God have his way. Will there be another? Will there be one today? Hallelujah. Step in. You want God to move on your behalf. You want God to work it out for you. You want God to strengthen you. You want God to give you more power, give you more patience. You want God to help you to be able to control your temper. You want God to be able to help you to be able to overcome when the enemy comes your way. You got sickness in your body and you don't know what to do, but I got news for you. I know a healer.
You had to slow your trouble out.
I know a healer. Heal you. He wants to deliver you. He wants to do it. He said, give it to me. He said, cast your cares upon me. I dare you to let it go today. I dare you to let him have it today. I dare you to trust him today. Here tonight, God. Lord, you know the situation that we're going through. You know, Lord, what touched our hearts, Master, that allowed us and caused us to come to the altar, Lord. Lord, we come, Lord God, recognizing, Master, that you are God. Recognizing, God, that you are able. Recognizing, God, that there's nothing too hard for you. Recognizing, God, that you can do everything fail. Lord, we come recognizing that there's no sickness that you cannot heal, that there's no pain that you cannot move, that there's no struggle that you cannot break, that there's no yoke that you cannot destroy. Lord, in the name of Jesus, have your way right now. Right now, God. We give it to you, Lord. We turn it over to you, Lord. We're letting you have it, Lord. And not only are we letting you have our problems, God, but we're letting you have us, Lord God. Have your way in us, Lord. Have your way in our lives. Work on us, Lord. Make us what you would have us to be, Lord. We surrender all, God. We surrender our hearts, God. We surrender our minds, God. We surrender our bodies, God. We surrender our lives, God. Here we are. Power, Lord. Move by your mighty spirit, God. Move by your mighty hand, Lord. Strengthen us, Lord God. Strengthen us where we're weak, Master. Build us up where we're torn down. Help us to live for you, God. Help us to lift your name high. Help us in all that we say and all that we do, God, to glorify you, Master. We realize, Lord, it's not about us, but Lord, it's all about you. All of these, your young people that are here tonight, God. Father, I pray, God, your covering upon them, Master. I pray, God, your strength upon them, God. I pray, God, that your power will rest within them, Lord. That your spirit will abide within them, Lord. That you will give them strength, God, to be able to stand, God, against all of the wiles and temptations of the devil, Lord. Help them, Lord God, to overcome, Master, in the name of Jesus. Bless this community, God. Bless this church family, God. Bless this pastor, Lord God. Bless this family, Lord God. Bless Morningstar, God. All of those that are here, Lord, assemble right now, Master. Let your blessings just flow in our lives. And Lord, we believe it, God. And we decree it, God. And we claim it, God. And we call it done right now, Master. In Jesus' name. Somebody lift your hands toward heaven. Lift your hands toward heaven and say, Lord, I thank you. It's already done. Lord, I thank you. It's already done. Lord, I thank you. I'm going on in your name. I trust you, God. I give it to you, God. Yes. Somebody tell him yes tonight. Somebody tell him yes tonight. Yes to your will, God. Yes to your way, God. Yes.
Bless you. Amen. We're getting ready to go. A program that we're ready to go. Here's the program for tomorrow night. I'm ministering music to you. Amen. Program. Amen. Amen. Amen.
My Lord.
Bless you. Let's thank God for it tomorrow night. Pastor Jenkins and Dapper Lee will be our guests. We thank God for all of you to come. May God richly bless you and keep you. Amen. Thank God for the message. Thank God for the messenger. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Let's all stand together and take us home.
Amen.
Amen.
You can't help me.
Yes.
Please, God.
way. Don't try to block me.
Yeah.
I got a race to run, y'all. Yeah.
Okay.
And I'm running by faith. At the finishing line, I see God's face. I said, you can't help me. Please don't stop me. Move out of my way.
God keep you. We just thank God again for allowing us to come, amen, and your pastor for inviting us and for you for accepting us. We thank God for Morningstar,
amen,
and all of our friends that came to be with you and to worship with you on tonight. God, continue to bless and bless this revival. God, be with us and go with us as we leave from this place. Give us your traveling grace and your traveling mercy. God, that we will be able to arrive home and find that all is well. Lord, continue to bless this revival. Bless every man of God that come and share and speak a word unto your people, Lord. Bless this pastor and this church, God. We ask all of these blessings in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you. Good night.
Good night.
Well, let me get a good one, though. Let me get, yeah, you know it.